Hi everyone, Anthony Fantano here, internet's busiest music nerd. Hope you're doing well, and it's time for a review of the new Lim Kim EP, Generation. This is a new EP of tracks from Korean singer and songwriter Lim Kim. If you somehow managed to hear Kim's music in the earlier portion of this decade, what you would have heard is something that sounded like another K-pop artist on the rise. The songs and production on her early singles are very sleek, very sweet, not too radical or even all that memorable. But then in 2015, Kim seemed to stop putting out more music. Now, several years down the road, she's made a radical and totally unexpected return. I'm no K-pop expert, that's for sure. But I'm pretty sure Kim is one of the few artists in the genre to make a comeback as an art pop avant-gardist, mixing elements of hip-hop, industrial music, Korean folk music as well. It's such a strange and aggressive combination of sounds, it's hard to pin down. There are elements of it that remind me of Death Grips, then of M.I.A. A bit of Fever Ray or The Knife, too. 21 minutes of material on this EP spread out among 6 tracks, and I'm just impressed with how uncompromising a majority of the tracks on this thing are, to the point where it all feels very difficult to take in at once, especially on the intro Minjokyo entrance, where Kim presents these heavy, banging Korean drums colliding with gigantic, monumental choral chants. Nothing about it seems too abrasive or too experimental, but it's still larger than life. It still hits like a ton of bricks, with its very resonant and bassy percussion, with its twisted vocal passages. And even though it's unlike many of the EP's other tracks, this song is still a great tone setter, and creative as well as edgy presentation of Kim's Korean roots, which she's obviously not going to be shy about on an EP titled Generation, or on a track titled Yellow for that matter. The next track on this EP is a total banger, essentially a statement of Asian female empowerment, with the title obviously being in reference to a historically pejorative reference to Asian people's skin color, which in the context of this song is being used as like a badge of honor. So if the opening track on this thing hit like a ton of bricks, this one hits like 2 tons of bricks being carried on Mack trucks just dropped on my head. And while the percussion and general instrumentation here may feature a lot of Eastern timbres, the grooves and composition this time around are a lot more like a hip-hop song. The plucky string arpeggios, the booming bass, loads of colorful sound effects and bells and whistles, get some trap hi-hats on this bitch and you can get the Migos to rap on it. Instead though, on top of this instrumental, Kim delivers this very bold, in-your-face, yelpy rap flow. It's incredibly slick, confident. Some of the opening lyrics on the track are cool, but the most attention-grabbing thing about Kim are her insane inflections. Also, the refrains of, "Who's the fucking queen? Who's the fucking queen?" A few of the similes in Kim's lyrics in the second half of the track are a little weak. A reference to wasabi, a reference also to ninjas. Moments that to me feel more like playing up stereotypes as opposed to breaking them down. I still can't deny this track is very creative though. It's very exciting, catchy, kind of a breath of fresh air. The next cut, Mong, is a breathy ballad loaded with serene instrumentation, some gently soaring vocals, and a subtle R&B influence, especially out of the chord progression here. It's undeniably seductive. These light bursts of plucky, very pronounced synths and twangy strings pair very well with the hip-hop inspired beat on the hook. Then we get Digital Con, which is another banger in the track list here. Bold intro, great build-up. Meanwhile, the main beat around the chorus of this track is pretty reggaeton inspired. Not really a sound or influence on this track I saw coming, but I guess the theme or concept of it is a global takeover with a lot of references to technology. It is Digital Con. Considering how hard the beat goes, how bold the vocals are, the international references and flavors throughout the track, this is one of many moments on this EP that just reminds me once again of M.I.A., creating this somewhat political and kind of radical combination of so many different sounds and influences across the world. Plus a chorus that goes harder than a prison riot. Yeah, 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 yeah! Worldwide anthem! Worldwide! The song Yo Soul is another low-key moment on the EP, though not as thoroughly satisfying as Mong, especially with its kind of weak ending. I do like the introductory beat and synths, though it seems like a weird combination of some old Hudson Mohawk and James Blake. There's a point at which it transitions into this very soft, melty passage with little in the way of a logical segue. It just changes suddenly into something a lot blander and more forgettable. And the closing track, even though in a way it is an answer to the intro, it's not in the same Korean folk vein that the intro was. Instead, it feels more like a detuned, wonky rap piece with revving bass, chunky beats, and some very sassy, almost R&B-inspired vocal harmonies. The initial moments of the song do drag on a little bit, especially as the instrumentation melts away and you get just more spotlit vocals, but once things transition into the explosive finish with more shouty vocal harmonies, massive drum hits, it's just eargasmic. Feels almost like the kind of sonic nightmare Fever Ray or The Knife would drum up in their most experimental moments. Overall, I think this is a very good EP. Will certainly be one of my favorite EPs of the year, though it didn't blow me away, left me wanting more, really. But still, I would love to hear Kim past this point try to take this sound and extend it out onto a project that is twice as long, and just see how versatile, uncompromising, even extreme she could go. I'm feeling a light to decent 7 on this one. Transition, have you given this EP a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video that you should check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Lim Kim, forever.